Hello friends, so you have installed your Visual Studio in your system and now you want to learn how to create your first project using Visual Studio 2017. Then this video is for you. My name is Nitish and I'm going to teach you how can you create your project, your first project of different types using Visual Studio. So if you don't have this window open, you can just go to here and then scroll down and then go to V section, because the name is starting from V. And then here you will see Visual Studio 2017. Click on this part and you will see your Visual Studio is opened in your system. So here, first of all, you will see a start page. So this is the mention the start page. You will see some different links about the Visual Studio 2017. Like if you want to learn about the new features in Professional 2017, then you can click on this link. It will open a page in the browser, which will have some different directions, different links or different information about this thing. So now you can learn what exactly is the new thing in .NET framework. So basically here are some new links which are available in the Visual Studio. Then here in this section you will see some recents. This means your recent projects will be here. So if you are working on some projects and then gradually you move on another one, then you will see here the list of your previous project. So basically here in this section, this is open part. So to open it, you can open a particular project, you can open a particular folder from your system, or if you want to create a new project, then you need to choose this section. So in this project, in this section, you have to type the name of the project. So if you want to create console application, you can write down the console application. If you want to create the web application, you can go with the web application or anything. So if you don't have a start page open in your Visual Studio, then to open it, go to file and then click on start page. You will see start page on your Visual Studio. So basically I'm going to teach you how can you create your project. So to create a new project, you can go to file section. This is the best and easiest way. So go to file, then choose the new tab, and then go to project, or simply you can press Control plus Shift plus N, Control Shift N, and you will see the same window will here. So basically here on the left panel you will see these three things. Recents, it means your recent projects you have worked on. If you haven't worked on any recent project, then it will be blank. Then you will see the installed, it means all the installed templates will be available in these sections. So basically there are different things in the Visual Studio. So suppose if you want to work with the web application, you can just install the web application only here. But if you want to work with .NET Core or console applications or web applications or mobile applications using Xamarin, iOS, etc. So you can install all the templates, and all the templates will be available here. So, and here it will have online templates. So if you don't have any template yet, you can go to the online section and can search, and you can use that particular section. Okay, so to open the installed, you will see here is a template thing. Expand the template one, you will see Visual C Sharp, Visual Basic, Visual F Sharp, SQL Server. So basically these are the types of the project. So if you want to create some project using C Sharp language, then you have to click on this menu. If you want to create something using Visual Basic, then you can click here. If you want to create something using Visual F Sharp, basically these are the types of project. If you want to create something using JavaScript or Python or TypeScript or SQL Server, you can choose the menu as per your requirement. So suppose I'm working with C Sharp language, then I will expand this one, first one. So you will see here Web, Windows Universal, Windows Classic Desktop, .NET Core. So you need to choose the particular type of the template you are going to use. So using Visual C Sharp, first I am choosing the Visual C Sharp, then the type of project. Basically it is a web application, or it is a console application, or it is a mobile application. So you will see like the Windows Universal means window application, the web application, .NET Core, .NET Standard, Android applications, cloud, cross platform, iOS. So basically you can choose as per your requirement. So suppose I am going to choose Visual C Sharp. So if you click on Visual C Sharp, all the templates with detail list will be available here on the right side. Okay, so suppose I want to create visuals using Visual C Sharp, I want to create some project. Here some more things are here to check. So in the top menu you can see the .NET framework, click on it. So basically, you know there are different versions of the .NET framework. So here, as per your requirement, as per your compatibility with the project, you can choose the .NET framework. Okay, and so suppose I'm working with console application. So to start a console application, you have to start it here, console app .NET framework. Now after choosing it, there are different things you have to enter. So come to the bottom part of this window. So there is a name. So it means the name of your project. You have to write the name of your project. So suppose I'm writing my project dot console. So it may be anything. It may be your website dot console. It may be your website dot web. It may be anything, the name of the project, then the location of the project you are going to save. So this is the location at this particular path your project will be saved. So you can change it. Click on the browse button. You can choose the location where you want to save your project and then click select folder. You can change it, and then the solution name. So by default the name of the project is the solution name, but you can always change it as per the requirement. So you know the difference between the name and the solution name. So basically solution, a particular solution can have multiple projects. So the solution is basically a group of different projects. So you can give a meaningful name to your solution name and a meaningful name to your project name, and then click on OK. So basically here is one more thing, create new Git repository, create directory for solution. So basically this is the part for the Git. If you are working with the repository part, you can click on this and it will create a local repository here. Then by syncing using the different tools like the Visual Studio tools or the Tortoise or the Git, you can just create your repository in the server side as well. So basically I created the first project, I provided the name, the location, the solution name, and click on OK. So you will see your project is available in your Visual Studio. So to see the solution explorer, you have to click on the view, then go to solution explorer, and you will see all the structure of the project is available here on the right side. So that's it. Using this technique, you can create your different projects as per the requirement. So this is a console application. If you want to create a new web application, you can go with the web application. If you want to create something in .NET Core, you can go with the .NET Core. So subscribe the channel to get different tips and tricks for the Visual Studio and different technology techniques. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.